26, Health is Real Wealth. Our protocol today is going to focus more on quality of movement, taking our joints to the end ranges and holding them under control actively. We're going to have 6 total movements. They're going to be broken up into 2 tri-sets. We'll complete each tri-set 4 times. Dun, dun, dun. Tri-set 1, exercise A, a 3-second bottom pause split squat. We're going to get into our split squat position. If you've got some external load, feel free to hold it in front of the body or 2 individual objects to the side. You're going to descend into your split squat pattern, keeping your weight on the front leg, pausing roughly an inch above the ground, holding for 1, 2, 3, drive that front heel into the floor to stand back up and repeat. 1, 2, 3, back up. Completing all 10 repetitions on the left side before moving into 10 repetitions on the other side. Movement B, a 3-second prone hip external rotation drill. Don't worry. You're gonna lay on your ground. You're gonna place your forehead on the ground. You're gonna bring one of your legs out into that external rotation position. And from here, you're gonna think about pushing your pelvis into the floor and squeezing your butt cheeks. From this position, imagine you are lifting your leg, the one that's out here on the side, up to the sky as high as you can, leading from the knee. 1, 2, 3, back down. Engage everything again. 1, 2, 3. Performing 10 on one side before moving on for 10 on the other side. We're gonna get into a quadruped position and perform a hip car controlled articular rotation. So from my quadruped position, I'm going to anchor half of my body into the floor. And I'm going to initiate this movement with one of my legs, one of my hips. I'm going to pull my knee as far to my chin as I possibly can. And then I'm going to lift it out to the side as wide as it can possibly go. Kind of like I'm a dog peeing on a fire hydrant. Now you'll notice that range of motion is coming from my hip, not my torso. I'm then gonna continue this circle, wrapping my hip as far around the range of motion that it has access to before starting that whole movement from the beginning one more time. The value here, again, is ensuring that we're pushing that joint to the very, very maximal end position it's got. After we've completed 3 in one direction, we shall reverse. So instead of starting with flexion, I'm now gonna start with extension of my hip, keeping my heel really close towards my butt. I'm gonna rotate so that I'm opening that hip out, trying to keep as much height as I possibly can, as I bring that knee back in towards my armpit, repeating this direction also for 3. So I'm gonna end up accumulating 6 reps per side because I'm challenging each direction 3 times. After you've completed 4 sets for tri-set 1, we're now gonna move on to tri-set number 2. Our first movement here, movement A of our second tri-set, is gonna be a bent over, thumbs up, lateral raise. If you've got some light weights at home, feel free to use them. If not, I'm hoping that body weight is gonna feel pretty heavy by the end of this. We're gonna get into our bent over position. Hanging our arms comfortably in front of our bodies. We're gonna initiate by pulling the shoulder blades back and down. I'm gonna raise my thumbs up towards the ceiling as high as I go, holding for a moment, back down. And up, reaching that end range again, back down. Reaching my end range, back down for a total of 20 repetitions. Movement B, a 10-second isometric row. So from laying on the ground, you're gonna push that lower back into the floor to create tension through the rest of the body. You're gonna think about driving your legs out and also thinking about pulling your heels towards your head. You're gonna imagine that you've got these long elastic bands attached to the ceiling. You're gonna grab onto those elastic bands and you are going to pull your shoulder blades and your elbows into the floor with as much tenacity and purpose, driving for 10 full seconds into the ground with everything that you possibly had. Not a lot of risk associated with this movement, so really make sure that you're bringing your A game here. Release after 10 seconds, take a moment, and perform that exercise one more time for another 10 seconds. We're gonna be accumulating 5 reps of 10 seconds. Our last movement of our second tricep is gonna be a shoulder car, controlled articular rotation from the quadruped position. Assume your position. We're gonna pick on my right hand here to start. I'm gonna ensure that the other 3 points of contact are keeping my body nice and stable. I'm going to bring my arm up into flexion, thumb towards the ceiling, as high as I possibly can, without actually moving my torso. When I am now blocked and I can't go any higher, I'm going to start to bring my arm behind me, rotating that shoulder internally so that the head of my shoulder is pointed to the ground, to the floor, and my thumb is pointed backwards up to the ceiling. Another way that I think about this is thumb to bum. Once you've gone to the end, we're going to start over. Again, these are best done slowly and controlled and really pressing every second to the end position of what you've got access to. Not uncommon to feel like you're about to cramp. Once you've completed 3 in that one direction, we are going to reverse 3 in the opposite direction. So our starting point here is going to be thumb to bum. Because our shoulder has been internally rotated to the floor, I'm going to lift as high as I possibly can. High. And when I've reached my end position, I'm going to start to unravel, kind of like I'm swimming, keeping my arm really high, before coming back down to the bottom and then restarting one more time. Once you've accumulated 4 sets, of tricep 2, you're done for today. But don't go too far because we got something fun for you coming up tomorrow. If these workouts have been helping you stay fit and a little bit less grumpy during quarantine, shoot us a like and subscribe to our channel. More to come.